Today I will be discussing the LLC architecture and give a very simple overview of this topology. For today I'll be covering why an LLC, what is an LLC and the various blocks in the LLC, zero voltage switching and resonant tanks, LLC versus LCC, also what is RE, hint it is not Reynolds number. I'll end up with some LLC terms. So why would you want to use an LLC? LLC converters are typically used in power supplies ranging from 150 watts up to 1 kilowatt. They can achieve very high efficiencies, sometimes up to 95%, much better than active clamp forward, full bridge, etc. They have the highest power density topology you can achieve. It is lower with both conducted and radiated EMI. There are a wide variety of applications that use the LLC topology, and it ranges from anything from appliances, battery chargers, TV, DIN rails, HEV charging, PC notebook adapters, and more. So what is an LLC? An LLC is a resonant converter topology which is comprised of two inductive elements, which is your LL, and one capacitive element, which is your C. These form a resonant tank. You can use this in either a half bridge, two switch application, or full bridge, which is four switches. Resonant operation helps to achieve zero voltage switching. So some quick LLC facts. LLC converters operate at a 50% duty cycle. This helps to maintain the resonant operation, and when you have resonant operation, this is how you can achieve zero voltage switching. An LLC controller controls the output voltage by adjusting the switching frequency. LLC converters are typically used in narrow VIN, VOUT applications. For VIN, this means a power factor correction or PFC is used on the input. And for VOUT, this implies applications with fairly consistent constant output voltages. Historically, applications like battery chargers, lighting, may switch to an LCC configuration. LCC can support a wider output range, but is less efficient than an LLC topology. I'll be discussing more on this later. What are the parts of an LLC? An LLC consists of four sections. There is a switch network, a resonant tank, a transformer stage, and then finally rectification. The switch network creates a square wave input for the resonant tank. The purpose of the resonant tank is to filter out the square wave into a sinusoidal waveform. For the half-bridge topology shown here, the peak-to-peak voltage of the sinusoid is just VN to ground. This is also used for driving S1 and S2. The transformer stage steps the sinusoid down to a lower voltage based on the turns ratio. And last but not least is the output stage, which rectifies the sinusoid to produce a DC output voltage. Zero voltage switching lowers switching losses because it significantly reduces the effects of the parasitic capacitances, which make it harder to turn on the FET. When hard switching, current is flowing into the gate and charging up the parasitic capacitance CISS, which is CGS plus CGD. As the charge builds up on the gate, the turn-on threshold is reached. Current begins to flow through the FET. The power loss is VDS times IDS. VDS begins to fall, and this pulls charge out of the gate because of CDS. Once VDS has fallen, CDS can no longer pull charge out of the gate, so now VGS can continue to rise, and this will continue to minimize the RDS on of the channel. The FET is now fully enhanced. So how does ZVS improve efficiency? When a FET is hard switched, the time spent in the linear region is power loss. So when you're hard switching, you can see the cross between the voltage falling and the current rising has some switching loss in the area shaded in green. When a FET is soft switched or zero voltage switched, the VI product is essentially zero. So this is why it's called soft switching, because there's minimal switching losses. How is ZVS achieved? There are four operating states in an LLC. State 1, current is delivered from the source to the resonant tank. In the second state, current flows through the body diode of S2. In state 3, the remaining energy in the resonant tank is transferred to the secondary side. In the final state, the resonant tank discharges back to the source through the body diode of S1. This cycle continues to repeat. As I mentioned earlier, the LLC can be in a half bridge or a full bridge configuration. The biggest difference is you have two more switches when you go for a full bridge. You have double the voltage range because it's plus and minus VN instead of just VN. And full bridge is typically used in applications that need more than 1 kilowatt of power. If you need less than 1 kilowatt of power, half bridge is usually the cheaper or more effective choice. You can make a resonant tank with only two elements. Here's an example of a series resonant tank. This works as a step down like a buck converter. At the resonant frequency, there's unity gain. When you're not at resonance, the gain is less than one. If you configure the LLC as a parallel resonant tank, this now works as a step up or like a boost converter. Here at the resonant frequency, the gain is much greater than one. With three element tanks, there are 36 possible combinations. Of these, only 23 work with pulsating voltage sources. Of these, only 15 have all three elements participating in resonance. And of these, only two are commonly used, and the only reason is these have the simplest control design. The LLC topology will be most efficient over a limited input-output voltage range, as the RMS input currents are lower. This is typically used in TV adapters, DIN rails, etc. The LCC topology is optimized to work over a much wider VN/Vout range, but it has higher RMS currents in the input, so the overall efficiency will be lower. This is typically used in battery charges and lighting, as they prefer this topology because they need the wider output support. In the resonant charts, you've been seeing this RE, so what is that actually? This is derived using a process called Fundamental Harmonic Approximation, or FHA. The output stage of the LLC is modeled as an equivalent resistor, which is called RE. If you look in the schematic here, VS is the first order harmonic of the switch network output. This is a simplified model as it is now a linear circuit that only looks at the fundamental harmonic that is a sinusoidal input voltage. This makes it easier to model the LLC circuit. An LLC converter is most efficient when it is resonating at the resonant frequency. Depending on the load, it can be between FR1 and FR2 as shown here. If somehow the LLC converter starts operating at a lower frequency than resonance, zero current switching can occur. This is also known as hard switching. When this happens, it is possible to have both FETs on at the same time, and bad things can happen to good FETs. When you hear the term capacitive region avoidance, this means the controller has a scheme to avoid entering the capacitive region. And finally, here are some terms you should be familiar with when discussing LLC controllers. The first is burst mode. This is a condition at light or no load where the controller briefly stops switching in order to improve light load efficiency. A controller typically has high and low thresholds for entering and exiting burst mode. The capacitive region is also known as zero current switching. This is an operating mode where the controller is not in resonance, meaning it is hard switching. In this mode, it is possible for the FETs to both be on at one time. This must be avoided to prevent damaging FETs. When operating in the capacitive region, current is flowing in reverse through the parasitic diode of the FET. This can lead to reverse recovery issues because the diode has reverse recovery time, so if the high side FET turns on, both FETs could be conducting at the same time, which will damage the FETs. When a device has high voltage startup, this means there's a high voltage linear regulator built in to facilitate startup. X capacitor discharge, or XCAP discharge, is circuitry that safely discharges the input voltage when you unplug the equipment from the wall. This is much more efficient than doing it passively. Dead time control describes the time between the low and the high side FETs. This is the time when they are both off. The goal here is to ensure that current is flowing in the switch before it actually fully enhances the switch. This ensures zero voltage switching. Thank you for watching, and please stay tuned, as our latest generation of LLC controller will overcome some of the limitations I discussed here today.